Streamline your workflow with common tasks and actions of apps that you use on a regular basis by creating a custom control panel using the Switch Control Panel Editor in Yosemite. Cue the music. Hi, I'm Serge Su and welcome to Mac Studio 8. In this episode, how to create your own custom control panel in OS X Yosemite. Shown here are some custom panels created using the panel editor. In OS X Mavericks, the custom panel was accessed from the main home panel. But in OS X Yosemite, you're able to assign the custom panel as the main home panel. Creating a custom panel is painless, easy, and lots of fun. Straight to the demo. So let's get started. To open the panel editor, launch System Preferences and click on the Accessibility icon. Scroll down and click on the Switch Control icon, then click on the Open Panel Editor button shown here. Click or press the Enter key on the New Panel button to rename it. I'll just name mine Mac Studio 8 Sidekick. Next, to launch your custom panel as the main panel, click the drop-down list of the Show option here and choose as Home Panel. Now for the fun stuff. Basically, this is the end result of the custom panel that we'll be creating. The control panel shown is based on assigning the following actions to the buttons: Open App, Press Keys, and System Event. Furthermore, the panel editor includes some very basic image buttons that you can use, or simply create your own using such apps as Preview or Pixelmator as I have done. What follows is a time-lapse of the formality involved for adding images to buttons and assigning actions to them, with the exception of the background button. Okay, after adding all the buttons to the custom panel, save your work and close the panel editor as shown. Before enabling the custom panel, you can choose when to hide the custom panel without inactivity. In my case, I'll choose a 5 seconds delay. Now, enable or disable the custom panel by either placing or removing a check mark to the box shown here. And voila, your custom panel is enabled and ready to use. And that's all there is to it. Streamlining your workflow using a custom Switch control panel could not be more simple. Go ahead, give it a try, and have fun doing it. Coming up in the next episode, how to share and import a custom control panel. Hope you'll join us. Thanks for watching, and thumbs up if you like this video. And please, don't forget to subscribe to be notified of the next episode. Thanks and peace.